Welcome to ISC Plus One History class. We are going to continue Lesson 3, Economic, Social and Cultural Impact of British Rule. Before going through the lesson, we have to understand the objectives of the lesson. The impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration, reform movements, Brahmo Samaj, the Arya Samaj movement and Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, struggles against caste, contribution of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru and Varsalingam Kandukuri, then abolition of sati rights, widow remarriage act of 1856 and lastly female infanticide prevention act 1870, the age of consent bill 1891 and the impact of this age of consent bill 1891. We had already discussed about the impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration. We had already discussed about Brahmo Samaj. We had also discussed about Arya Samaj and the movement led by Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. In the last session, we had discussed the struggle against caste, where we have done the contribution of three leaders, Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru and Varsalingam Kandukuri. In this session, we are going to discuss about abolition of sati rights, widow remarriage act of 1856. Before going ahead, we will discuss the new terms of the lesson. Apprehensive, worried or afraid that something unpleasant may happen. Persuasive, able to convince somebody to do or believe something. Countenanced, admit as acceptable or possible. Orientalist, someone from the Western countries who studies the language, culture, history or customs of countries of Eastern Asia. And the last term is petition, written appeals for something. In the 19th century, along with the reforms in religion, social reforms were also advocated by reformers. The end of sati was perhaps the most fruitful of all the social reform movements. So firstly in this session we will discuss the efforts in the direction of ending sati system. Sati, we had been discussing in many previous session also, was a system according to which a woman was forced to die on the funeral pyre of her dead husband, and because ending sati was a long struggle, so we will discuss it in two stages. Firstly, we will discuss the first stage. In the first stage, Christian missionaries William Carey and an Indian, Mrityunjay Vidyalankar, put forward their efforts. In 1772, Christian missionaries appealed to Lord Cornwallis, who was the Governor General at that time, to end sati system, but these efforts were in vain. These efforts were not successful, as at that time the government had adopted the policy of benevolent neutrality. That means not to interfere in the social and cultural life of the Indians. William Carey, who himself was the Governor General of India, consulted with the pundits of Fort William College and convinced people that sati was not compulsory by Shastras. So he convinced the people, he tried to tell the Indian people that it is not written in Hindu scriptures that sati should be performed by the Indian women. It was not compulsory by the Indian scriptures. Then Mrityunjay Vidyalankar was of view that practice of sati is voluntary and should not be imposed on any widow. He was of view that any women should not be forced to perform sati against her wishes. Now we will discuss the removal of sati in its second stage. In second stage, Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Lord William Bentinck came forward to end the sati system. Raja Ram Mohan Roy, who is often called as the father of Indian Renaissance, he started the anti-sati vigilance party, a party to look after that how many women were dying because of sati. He published the journals in 1818, 1819 and 1829. In the direction of ending sati system in India, his most popular journal was Sambad Kamuri. Raja Ram Mohan Roy believed that the ending of sati in India should be a slow process. because immediate abolition of sati would lead to dissatisfaction against British. If British would end sati system, immediately that Indians would be provoked against the British, so it should be ended slowly and slowly from India. The second person was Lord William Bentinck, who was the Governor General of India. He was a reformer by nature. He consulted Raja Ram Mohan Roy and H.H. Wilson, who was an Orientalist. Orientalist, we have already done in new term, is a person from Western countries who lives in the Eastern countries and study the history and culture of the Eastern countries. He was in favor of total eradication of sati system, where Raja Ram Mohan Roy believed in the slow process of eradication. Lord William Bentinck believed in the total end or total eradication of sati. So on December 4, 1829, sati was declared illegal and punishable by law courts under Regulation 17 of 1829 Act. And when Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Lord William Bentinck were putting forward their efforts to end the sati system in India, there were some conservative led by Raja Radhakant Deb of Bengal. These were the person who did not want the end of sati system in India. Now, along with the sati system, there was another issue, another social problem, whether or not the widow should be allowed to remarry or not. So Widow Remarriage Act in this direction was passed in 1856. In the middle of the 19th century, there were many organizations and persons who worked in favor of Widow Remarriage Act, like British India Society, Young Bengal Group, which was started by Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Raja Ballab of Dhaka, this place is now in Bangladesh. These were the persons or the organizations which wanted the eradication of child marriage and wanted that widow should be allowed to remarry. Raja Ballab's own daughter got widow at a very tender age and he wanted to give her in marriage. But there were some conservative person like Raja Krishna Chandra of Nadia who did not want widow should be remarry. So all these efforts were in vain. Then Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar came in active politics and he was the person who did a lot for passing of Widow Remarriage Act in India. He was born in 1820 and died in 1891. He got the title of Vidyasagar as he was very intelligent. In 1851, he became the principal of Sanskrit College. He wrote a journal on widow remarriage in 1855 on the basis of Shastras. That means he tried to convince the Indian people that Shastras has given permission for the widow remarriage. Against him, a petition was signed, a written appeal was signed by the Zamindars, and the Zamindar group was led by Raja Radhakant Deb. He is the same person who criticized Raja Ram Mohan Roy for his effort for ending the sati system in India. Now, with the initiative of J.P. Grant, who was a member of Legislative Council, on July 26, 1856, under Regulation 15, 1856 Act, the widow remarriage was legalized in India. So, widow remarriage became more popular, especially in northern and western India. In northern India, it was popularized by Arya Samaj, and in Western India, it was popularized by Satyashodhak Samaj. Though Widow Remarriage Act had got legal sanction, still it failed to find a wide acceptance in Hindu society because of orthodoxy and conservative Hindu society. But we cannot say that the passing of Widow Remarriage Act or the ending of sati was not fruitful for the Indian society. At least The Hindu society felt the need of reform in the society. So both these social reforms, the ending of sati system and the passing of widow remarriage act, tried to reform the Hindu society. I hope you have understood till here. With the help of this notes and internet, you are required to make the notes of above topic. Thank you.